Welcome back to the online class, students. In this class, we are going to discuss about MCQ questions of chapter chemical coordination and integration under brain teaser level in class exercise. First question, read the statement and identify which of them is true or false. First statement, release of oxytocin is due to uterine contraction is a positive feedback control. That is a true. Hormones are also secreted by diffused cells. True. Hormones are intracellular messengers. Actually, they are intercellular messengers. This is a false statement. Some hormones are produced in inactive form. That is true. Then we are supposed to choose the statement which is having true, true, false, true. That is option 2 is our answer. Okay. Then, second question. The bronzing of skin is the symptom of. Bronzing means hyperpigmentation of skin. First option, myxedema, Addison's disease, acromegaly, none of this. So the answer is Addison's disease, which is caused by hyposecretion of ACTH. Third question, hormone adrenaline and pigment melanin are formed from which amino acid? Okay, so the options are tryptophan, second one, glycine. Then the third option is proline. Fourth option is tyrosine. The answer is tyrosine. Next question. STH, growth hormone, nothing but growth hormone, acts on the organs through somatomedin, which is secreted mainly from liver, thymus, hypothalamus and kidney. We know that these are the endocrine glands. Okay. So whereas, which has been formed in the liver. The answer is liver. Then the following figure shows two different hormones, both of which can act on smooth muscle cells in the uterus. Select the option that correctly identifies the two hormones. Okay. So hormone A, so you can see that, so which is attaching to the receptor found on the membrane. Okay. That means it is a protein based hormone. Option B is the hormone which is directly entering inside the cell, which is having the receptor inside the cell. That is a steroid hormone. So, hormone A, hormone B. First one, relaxin, oxytocin, both are protein based. That is not the answer. Estrogen and progesterone. Estrogen acts on the ovary. FSH, estrogen. Here also FSH is a protein based one, which also acts on the ovaries. Oxytocin and progesterone. Oxytocin is a protein base. Progesterone is a steroid base. So, which act on the uterus smooth muscle cell. That is our answer. Next, which of the following hormones given below are polypeptide or proteinaceous in nature? First one, oxytocin, protein based. Growth hormone, protein based. MSH, protein based. Whereas thyroxine is a steroid. ACTH is a protein, estradiol is a protein based one. That is, so our answer should have 1, 2, 3 and 5. That is option 1. Okay. Next, hormone which interact with intracellular receptors. Okay. So that means the steroid hormones. Okay. So first option, regulate gene expression. Second, are steroids and iodothyronines? Yes. Then interact as hormone receptor complex with the genome. So all of these. So this is a character of steroid hormones. The answer is all of these. Okay. Next, which of the given hormones are secreted by pineal gland? Okay. So, first one, FSH, serotonin, MSH, prolactin, ACTH, melatonin. Okay. So, actually, the pineal gland produces serotonin as well as, so the melatonin. So, option 1 is the answer. Okay. The next question, pot-bellied and pigeon-chested with protruded tongue are the symptom of the following disease. Graves' disease, cretinism, Siemens disease, Cushing's syndrome. So, cretinism, hypothyroidism causes the above mentioned symptom. Okay. Next, which of the following vitamin acts as a steroid hormone? Okay, which acts as a steroid hormone? Option, vitamin B2, vitamin C, vitamin A1, vitamin D3. So, vitamin D3 acts as a steroid hormone. Next, read the statement and select the correct option. First one, cortisol is involved in coping up with the long-term stress. Okay, so which is a correct statement. Okay, then cortisol affects carbohydrate metabolism. Yes, that is also a correct statement. Then next, aldosterone acts on PCT, that is proximal convoluted tubule, to increase absorption of electrolytes and water. Actually, aldosterone acts on DCT, distal convoluted tubule. So, this is a wrong statement. Removal of pituitary affects levels of hormones from adrenal gland. Okay, so it is not only going to affect the adrenal gland, even the other endocrine glands are also affected. That is wrong statement. So, option 1, statement 1 and 3 are correct. Statement 2 and 4 are correct. In statement, second option, statement 1 and 2 are correct. Statement 3 and 4 are incorrect. Third option, statement 2 and 3 are correct. Statement 1 and 4 are incorrect. Fourth option, statement 1, 2, 3 are correct. Statement 4 is incorrect. So, our answer should be, first and second should be correct. Third and fourth should be incorrect. That is option second. Okay. Next, which of the following is correct? Okay, then thyrocalcitonin is a hypercalcemic factor. So, it is not hypercalcemic, it is a hypocalcemic factor. Okay, so that is wrong. Then, parathyroid hormone increases the calcium level in the blood. Yes. Then, thymosin plays a major role in the differentiation of T lymphocytes. Yes. Then, parathyroid glands are present on back side of the thyroid gland. So, the correct statements are 2, 3 and 4. Our option is, second one is our answer. Okay. The next question is, the brain associated structures that function as master clock are hypothalamus, pituitary gland, epithalamus, fourth one, pineal gland. So, in the above mentioned, which are correct? Okay, which act as a master clock are, so that is epithalamus and pineal gland. So, epithalamus means it's a like the dorsal part of the forebrain. Okay, and pineal gland act as a master clock. Hence, option 3 is our answer. Then, sample of urine was diagnosed to contain high content of glucose and ketone bodies. Okay. First statement, which endocrine gland and hormone is related to this condition? Name the cell on which this hormone acts. Okay. Then continuation of the question. Okay. So the next is, what is the condition called and how can it be rectified? Which of the following statements are correct in relation to the above statement? Okay, so we are supposed to mention which is the gland and what is the hormone and how it can be rectified. Okay, for high content of glucose and ketone bodies in the urine. Okay, so first option, thyroid, thyroxine, all body cells. Third, cretinism by introducing the iodine. Second statement, another, adrenal gland, aldosterone. So, all body cells. Then, Addison's disease by sodium treatment. Third one, pancreas, insulin hormone, all body cells, diabetes mellitus by injecting insulin. Fourth one, parathyroid, parathormone hormone, all body cells, myxedema by introducing the calcium. So, high amount of glucose that is due to the, by injecting the insulin, we can, that can be treated. So, our option is pancreas, insulin, all body cells, it acts on all body cells. The symptom, the disease is diabetes mellitus, it can be treated by injecting insulin. Okay, next question. Which of the following are the symptoms of hypersecretion and hypersecretion of insulin? Okay, sweating, irritability, glycosuria, hypoglycemia. Okay, so the symptoms are sweating can be seen, irritability, and so the hypoglycemia are seen because of hypersecretion of insulin. So our option is, that is first statement, first, third and fourth. Second statement, first, second and third. Third, first, second, third and fourth. Fourth, first, second and fourth. So our answer should be first, second and fourth. This is the answer. The next, which of the following is correct? Okay, so first one, pars distalis produces GH, prolactin, TSH, ACTH, LH, FSH. Okay, that is correct. Pars intermedia secretes a hormone called melatonin. That is correct. The next, posterior lobe of pituitary is also called as neurohypophysis or pars nervosa. Yes. Then posterior pituitary stores and releases two hormones called as oxytocin and vasopressin. That means all the statements are correct. So the option 3 is our answer. Then next, synergistic set of hormones include. Okay. So synergistic set of hormones include. That is when the individual effect of the hormone is compared with the combination of, when two hormones are combined, it shows more effect. Okay, so that is the meaning of synergistic set. So first option, estrogen, progesterone, prolactin and oxytocin. Second option, insulin and glucagon. So second one, parathormone and calcitonin. So fourth one, both first and third. Okay, so these are antagonistic in action, opposite in action, these two, whereas estrogen, progesterone, prolactin and oxytocin are considered as synergistic in effect. Okay, so option 1 is the answer. The next, which of the following statement about calcitonin is false? It reduces the renal tubular absorption of calcium. It's correct. It reduces the number and activity of osteoclast. Yes. Then its deficiency commonly causes tetany. So tetany is actually caused by parathyroid hormone, not by calcitonin. That is the wrong one. Then it reduces the renal tubular absorption of phosphate. So the wrong statement is its deficiency commonly causes tetany is the answer. Okay. Next question is, chronic gonadotropin hormone is similar in function to the following hormone. Chorionic gonadotropin hormone is similar in function to the following hormone. That is progesterone, FSH, LH, then somatomapotropin. So whereas chorion gonadotropin, which is similar in structure and function with the LH. So our answer is 3. Then when the BP is high and overloading of heart is present, then which hormone is released for compensating this mechanism? Okay. So ADH, aldosterone, renin, then ANF. So our heart produces ANF. So which helps in decreasing the blood pressure? Fourth one is the answer. Then which of the hormone given below are amino acid derivatives? Okay, insulin, glucagon, epinephrine, norepinephrine, testosterone, estradiol. Okay, so which is based on amino acid is epinephrine and norepinephrine, whereas insulin and glucagon are protein based, testosterone and estradiol are the steroidal hormones, lipid based. Okay, so our answer is, it should be 3 and 4. So first option is our answer. Then, hypocalcemic tetany mainly occurs due to by adrenal glands. Okay, first option, first statement, under function of parathyroid gland, hypersecretion of parathormone, hyposecretion of thyroid hormone, when concentration of calcium is less than the normal in the blood. Okay, so this is actually caused by hypocalcemic tetany, is mainly caused by under function of parathyroid gland, as well as when the concentration of calcium is less in the blood because of under function of the parathyroid gland. So that is our answer is 2. Then, choose the correct match with respect to the progesterone hormone, its source and function. Okay. So, first one, supports pregnancy. Okay. Then, synthesized mainly by growing ovarian follicles. Then, stimulates formation of alveoli in reptiles, mammary glands actually. Okay, so choose the incorrect statement regarding progesterone hormone. So here the option is supposed to be, it's supposed pregnancy is correct. It is synthesized by the growing ovarian follicles. So that is a wrong one. Okay, so which is incorrect is option 2 and 3 are the incorrect statements. Okay, then, which hormone promotes the descent of testes into the scrotum? Okay, so the scrotum will scrotum is a sac-like structure which encloses the testes. Option 1, testosterone, progesterone, oxytocin and estradiol. So the answer is testosterone. Okay, which is found in the males. Okay, then read the following statements. First one, TCT thyrocalcitonin is hyperglycemic agent. Okay, calcitonin is non-iodized. Third one, calcitonin regulates the calcium levels in the blood. Then the fourth statement is that is calcitonin is secreted by parafollicular cells. Select the appropriate option containing correct statements. Okay, so which is the correct statement here? So first one is TCT. TCT is hyperglycemic agent. So TCT is a hypoglycemic agent. Okay, so that is it wrong. The correct one is second one, calcitonin is non-iodized. Then calcitonin regulates the blood calcium levels. Then fourth statement, so calcitonin is secreted by parafollicular cells. Okay, so the correct option is it should contain second, third and fourth. That is option 1. Next, median eminence and pars tuberalis in pituitary gland are part of. Okay, that is adenohypophysis, neurohypophysis, adeno and neurohypophysis respectively. Fourth one, hypothalamus and adenohypophysis respectively. So this is a part of hypothalamus and adenohypophysis respectively. The fourth one is our answer. Then read the statements. Here we are supposed to choose the correct statements. Okay, hypothyroidism causes goiter. Yes, then hypothyroidism causes irregularity of menstrual cycle. Yes,
Then hypothyroidism causes cretinism in children. Yes. Then hypothyroidism adversely affects the body physiology. Yes. So that means select the appropriate options containing the correct statement. That is, all the four statements are correct. So our option is, it should contain all the four. That is 3. Okay. Next, low secretion of dash, that is A hormone, since birth results in stunted growth causing B, that is a disease, excess amount of hormone A at adolescence leads to individuals that suffer from C. Choose the option that fills the blank suitably. So here stunted growth, okay, so which is related to the growth, okay, hormone from the birth, stunted growth causing. So what causes stunted growth means that is related to the pituitary dwarfism, okay. Then excess of amount of hormone causes acromegaly in case of the adult. So that is the fourth one is our answer. Next one. Next question. Osteitis fibrosa cystica develops due to. Okay. So that is develops due to hypothyroidism, hyperparathyroidism, hypoparathyroidism. Fourth one, hyperthyroidism. So actually it is due to the hyperparathyroidism. So where you can see the, so the development of bones. Okay. So that is due to the hyperparathyroidism. Second one is the answer. The next question. One morning, milkman's cow refuses to give any milk. His wife gets the calf from the shed. On fondling by the cow gave sufficient milk. Which of the following statements are correct in relation to this above statement? Okay. So first option is, fondling by calf stimulated the nervous system to activate pituitary gland to secrete prolactin and oxytocin. Yes. Then oxytocin stimulates ejaculation of milk by mammary glands. Yes. Then prolactin stimulates the mammary glands to release the milk. So here all the mentioned statements are correct. So the fourth option is all the above are correct. So that is our answer. Next, mark the incorrect statement. First one, enzyme secretin in pancreas is stimulated by CCK means calcitokinin hormone. That is correct. Then, failure of testosterone secretion results in eunuchoidism. That means, so failure of development of sexual behavior. Okay. That is a eunuchoidism. So when the testosterone is not there, so there is a lack of sexual behavior. Yes, that is also correct. Then HCG is secreted from the ovary. Okay, it is not secreted from the ovary, secreted from the placenta. So castration changes an aggressive ox into a ductile bull. Okay, so castration means, so that is actually the removal of testicles. Okay, that is also correct. The wrong one is third option. Okay, next question. Cholesterol based hormone is released from option one, adrenal medulla only. Second option, both adrenal cortex and medulla. Third, adrenal cortex only. Fourth, testes and ovary. Cholesterol based, progesterone, estrogen, and testosterone produced from the testes and ovary, and even some from the adrenal cortex. Okay. That is, our option should contain 3 and 4. So that is option 4 is our answer. Okay. Next question. Which of the following is is the most likely explanation for hypothyroidism in a patient whose iodine level is normal. Okay, so whether person is having the normal iodine level, but most likely explanation for hypothyroidism. Okay, first one, hyposecretion of TSH, thyroid stimulating hormone, hypersecretion of thyroid releasing hormone, hyposecretion of TCT, hypersecretion of TSH. Okay, the answer is when TSH is less, so the person will be having hypothyroidism. That is option 1 is our answer. Next question. Osteoporosis can occur due to, first one, decreased levels of estrogen or increased levels of parathyroid hormones. Okay, next, because when the parathyroid hormone is more, so it dissolves the calcium from the bone and increases the blood calcium level. Okay, so that is a correct statement. Let us see the some other options also. Decreased levels of parathyroid hormone or increased levels of thyrocalcitonin. Okay, next, decreased levels of estrogen or parathyroid hormone. Increased levels of estrogen or decreased levels of parathyroid hormone. So the answer is, so the decreased levels of parathyroid hormone. Sorry, increased levels of parathyroid hormone. Option 1 is our answer. Then, read the following statements. First one, stimulate breakdown of lipid and protein. Second, stimulate breakdown of glycogen. Third, increase of heartbeat. Then fourth statement is increase of respiration rate. Above statements are related to which hormone? That is, actually all these symptoms we can see it during emergency situations like the fight and fear conditions. Okay, so first option is parathyroid, second thyrocalcitonin, third catecholamines, fourth thymosin. So during emergency situation, all these symptoms are seen, adrenaline and noradrenaline is produced, together we call it as catecholamines. 3 is the answer. Next question, identify the function of androgens. First, stimulates spermatogenesis. Yes. Then, act on central nervous system and influence libido. Okay, the sexual behavior, libido means. Yes. Then, produced anabolic effect on proteins and carbohydrate metabolism. That is also correct. Then, the fourth option is, statement is, stimulate muscular growth, aggressiveness and low pitch voice in the males. Okay, that is also correct. Then, androgens stimulate the growth of facial and axillary hairs. Okay, so all the statements are correct. Our option should contain 1 to 5. So that is, option 2nd is our answer. Okay, then, which of the following statements are incorrect? First one, oxytocin stimulates uterine contraction, that is during childbirth, that is correct. Then ACTH stimulates the release of adrenaline from adrenal medulla. Then insulin stimulates glycogen breakdown in the liver. Then thyroxine stimulates metabolic process. Okay, so incorrect statements are, so that is second and third. So the answer is, because adrenaline is produced during the emergency situations. Okay, insulin helps in the formation of glycogen. Hence, these two are the wrong statement. Option 1 is our answer, containing 2 and 3.